Hi, welcome to lecture 3 of airframe structural analysis. In last lecture I have asked some question, these are the answers. Limit within which Hooke's law is valid, that is your proportional limit. Then what is flexural rigidity? It is nothing but the product of Young's modulus capital E and area moment of inertia capital I. Poisson ratio can be defined as the ratio of lateral strain to longitudinal strain. Stress due to suddenly applied load is 2 times that of gradually applied load. These are the answers. In this lecture, we will see about theory of simple bending, the expression for bending stress, then we will see a numerical. When a beam is loaded, it will bend and will be subjected to bending moment. Bending stress is induced in this cross section. As you can see in the figure, you have a beam section before bending, before loading condition. This is essentially straight. After some day, this will bend like a circular arc. Okay, so we will be having certain axes like neutral axis. We'll discuss about that. So when the beam will up, when the beam is subject to some amount of load, this will bend in a circular arc. Now we'll see some assumptions in this theory. First one is the beam is assumed to be initially straight. Second one, the material of the beam is homogeneous and isotropic. Homogeneous means the properties are same at each and every point. Isotropic means elastic properties are same in every direction. The stress is proportional to strain and stress does not exceed the elastic limit. Next assumption, the value of Young's modulus or modulus of elasticity is same in compression and tension. Fifth one, the transverse section of a beam which is plane before bending remains plane after bending. Last assumption is an important assumption, elongation above a particular axis is proportional to distance from the particular axis. It's an important assumption, and these assumptions we are using for derivation for symmetrical bending stress expression as well as unsymmetrical bending stress expression. Now we'll go to the theory. This is the section of the beam before bending. As a result of couple, what is couple? It is nothing but a equal and opposite force or moment. This is your couple. So we are applying equal, there is equal and opposite load here in this direction. As a result of this couple, there will be a curve, there the beam will bend like a curved shape. And this can be assumed as an arc. In this case, we have a sagging moment, that is the beam is subjected to a positive bending moment. So this outer radius will be having tensile stress and the inner radius will be having a compressive stress. Okay. Now in between these layers, we will be having a certain layer in which there is no bending stress or stress. That layer is called neutral layer. We can see at a layer here that is denoted by capital N and capital A, this layer, this dotted line, or this layer is having no bending stress. Okay, so between this outer radius, outer layer and inner layer, we'll be having a layer in which there is no bending stress, that is called neutral layer, and the axis passing through it called neutral axis. Now we'll derive the expression for bending stress. Consider a cantilever beam which we are applying a load capital P at the tip, at the free end. Now we are taking a section here, section capital A, capital A. This is a section here and this is the centroidal axis. We are considering a layer here. This is a shaded layer and the area of the layer is D capital A. And this layer is at a distance y from the centroidal axis of the section. Consider a cantilever beam with the load P. It is mentioned here. So this layer having an area dA is at a distance of capital Y from the centroidal axis of the section. By Hooke's law, we know your stress is proportional to strain, that is sigma is equal to your Young's modulus into strain. By assumption, we have elongation above a particular axis is proportional to distance from the particular axis. So I can write elongation is nothing but the strain here. So strain is equal to, strain is proportional to y. So I can write strain is equal to a constant k into y. That is equation number 2. Equation 1 is sigma is equal to capital E into the strain. Epsilon is equal to k into y. That is the equation number 2. Now we will substitute equation number 2 in equation number 1. So sigma is equal to Ek into y. Ek, E and k are a constant. So I can write sigma y, sigma divided by y is equal to a constant from equation number 3. Now the force on the layer, the force on this particular layer, that is this layer we are considering, the force on this layer, that is df, is equal to the stress into the area of the layer, that is sigma into da. So that is eky into da. Total force on the section is integral of this equation. So integral of eky da, and the total moment is capital M is equal to eky da into the perpendicular distance, that is eky da into y. Ek are constants, so I will take out of the integral, so it will be Ek integral y square da. That is the total moment acting on the section. What is this integral y square da? That is nothing but area moment of inertia about x axis. Integral y square da is the area moment of inertia about x axis. Integral x square da is the area moment of inertia about y axis. And integral x by da is the product moment of inertia ixy. So I can get this expression ek into capital I is equal to m. From this expression I can write ek, that is a constant, e and k are constant here, e is a Young's modulus, k is a constant, e and k is equal to m divided by moment of inertia I. So from equation number 3, it's equation number 3, sigma divided by, that sigma by y is equal to e into k, that's also a constant. So we'll comparing equation number 3, 4 and equation number 5, that is equation number 5 is sigma by y is equal to ek, so equation number 4 is ek is equal to m by y, m divided by I. We can get sigma divided by y is equal to m divided by I. Finally I will be getting sigma is equal to m y divided by I. That is equation number 6. This is the equation for bending stress. I repeat, sigma is equal to m into y divided by capital I, where m is the bending moment, y is the distance from an axis, and capital I is the area moment of inertia. We have two moments of inertia. One is area moment of inertia, second one is mass moment of inertia. Area moment of inertia is nothing but the resistance of a section or something to bending, and mass moment of inertia is resistance to rotation. Now from equation number 6, I can get sigma max is equal to m into y max by I. That is, you will be having more amount of bending stress at the region where value of y is large. So I have equation, I can write this equation as m divided by I by y max. Okay, so that is I by y max is a term called section modulus. That is, section modulus is nothing but moment of inertia divided by y max. So I can rewrite the equation of bending stress as sigma max is equal to moment divided by section modulus, m by capital Z. And whenever we are selecting a section for bending, we need a section which is having more amount of section modulus. To resist a bending moment, we need section which is having higher amount of section modulus. For an example, for aircraft wing, we have something called spar. Spar is nothing but a structural number which will provide as front end of the wing as well as civil avoid twisting of the wing. This bar is having an I section as the section of the beam. So for spar to resist bending load, we are providing I section, because I section is having more amount of section modulus when compared to other sections like circular section, rectangular section or J section. That's why we are providing I section as a design for spar design. So whenever we are using, we are selecting a section for bending application, we have to consider section modulus. When section modulus is high, it can resist more bending moment and it can take more bending stress. So you have to understand sigma is equal to m into y divided by I, where m is the moment, bending moment, y is the distance from an axis, and capital I is the moment of inertia or area moment of inertia. Now we will go for a problem. Find the bending stress distribution and position of neutral axis in the cross section given below when it is subjected to bending moment as shown. So in this figure we have a rectangular section and it is providing a bending moment along x axis as well as y axis. So mx is 3200 newton centimeter, my is 4500 newton centimeter, and the value of width is 3 centimeter and the depth is 4 centimeter, and we are providing the bending moment along the line of symmetry of the section. So this point O will be the origin, and they are asking to find out the bending moment at point A, B, C and D. First of all, this is the bending stress equation when you are applying a bending moment along x and y. Sigma z is equal to mx divided by I xx into y plus my divided by iyy into x. So we will derive this equation later. So this is a basic equation through which we can find out the bending stress distribution of a symmetrical section, where I axis is the moment of inertia about x axis and iyy is the moment of inertia about y axis. We have to find out the value of I axis and iyy. Mx and my is already given. I axis is nothing but 1 by 12 b d cube by 12. Substitute the value, we will get the equation as 16 centimeter power 4, and iyy is equal to 1 by 12 db cube, that is equal to 9 centimeter power 4. Okay, now you substitute the value of moment as well as moment of inertia, we will get the bending stress equation. You substitute the value of mx, my, ixx, iyy, you will get the equation in terms of x and y. That is the bending stress equation. So you will be getting sigma z is equal to 200y plus 500x. This is the bending stress equation for the section. So you can see that sigma z is equal to 200y plus 500x. That is the bending stress equation. Now we have to find out the bending stress at point A, B, C, D. Now this point O will be acting as the origin. Now we have to find out the x and y coordinate of A, B, C, D with respect to the origin point O. So for point A, the coordinates are, this is minus x axis, this is minus y axis, this is plus x and this is plus y. At point A will be having an x coordinate as minus 1.5, y as 2. For point B it will be 1.5 and 2, and point C it will be 1.5 and minus 2, and point D it will be minus 1.5 and minus 2. So substitute the value of x and y coordinate in the bending stress equation, we can find out the value of bending stress at each and every point of the section. So sigma z at A section A will be 200 in times 2 plus 300 into minus 1.5. So we will be getting minus 350 newton per centimeter square. Whenever we have a negative value, that will be a tensile stress. Whenever we will be having a positive value, we will be having compressive stress. So we can see at point A, we will be having a tensile load. At point B, we will be having a compressive stress, that is 1150 newton per centimeter square. and point C will be having 350 newton per centimeter square. At point D will be having minus 1150 newton per centimeter square. This is just substituting the value of x and y in the Bennison's equation. So you'll be having maximum compressive stress as 1150 newton per centimeter square and maximum tensile load as minus 1150 newton per centimeter square. So we have found out the distribution of bending stress throughout your beam section, sorry, section. Now we have to find out the inclination of neutral axis. We are aware that neutral axis is an axis along which bending stress is equal to 0. So we have the bending stress equation, that is sigma is equal to 200y plus 500x. So 200y plus 500x is equal to 0. Just substitute the value of sigma is equal to 0. Then find out the value of y by x, that is a tan theta. That is minus 500 by 200. We will be getting tan theta as minus 2.5. So finally, we will get theta as minus 68.19 degrees. This is the inclination of your neutral axis. Hope you understand this problem. This is very easy. Just substituting the value, you have to find out the value of moment of inertia. Then you have to find out the coordinate at A, B, C, D. At A, B, C, D with respect to the origin point O, then you have to substitute the value of your x and y in the bending stress equation to find out the value of your bending stress at a particular point. Then substitute the value of bending stress equation as 0. Then take the slope y by x to find out the value of your inclination of neutral axis. This is the procedure to find out bending stress distribution as well as the position of neutral axis for a symmetrical section. Now you have a question here. I will provide the answer in the next lecture. A 7075 T6 aluminium has a radius of 2 mm. The stress analysis calculated the this rod with a maximum tensile axle load ranging from 2000 newton to 2700 newton. Any plastic deformation of this rod result in a loss of component functionality. The rod is a part of class S component, that is for flight condition, with a program mandated N is equal to, N is something but safety factor, is equal to 3. A 7075 T6 aluminium has a tensile yield strength of 500 MPa and ultimate strength of 580 MPa. So they are asking, is the design is safe? You have to just find out the volume of your safety factor. If safety factor is above 3, it won't be safe. If it is below 3, it will be safe. Thank you.